Back in the day, athletes would have everyone's respect in the neighborhood, especially boxers. They were off limits. Why? Because once the boxers make it, and I see this to this day on a regular basis, they go back to the neighborhood and make a difference in other people's lives. Whether they build centers, whether they donate money, or whether they inspire someone to be successful. All positive things. And that's why what I experienced this weekend, along with six boxers, really caught me off guard. I was working on a feature about four professional fighters and two amateurs, about how much time, effort, sweat, and blood they're putting into their craft, how much they're sacrificing, everything, just to make it, just to become champions. And one of these boxers is a former Olympian, and I'm telling you, these guys are some of the best fighters in Southern California. What happened? In the end of the day, it got pretty late. We stopped by Pico Rivera to get something to eat, and as we're exiting our vehicles, we were approached by five suspects, three of them with guns. And with guns to our faces, inches away, we were robbed. They took my camera, so you're not going to see the report. They took other people's cell phones, iPods. They pistol whipped one person and they sucker punched another.
The intersection of Rosemead and Washington.
And what happened here tonight?
You guys got robbed.
Got jacked, man.
Got jacked by how many gangsters with guns?
Like 10 of them.
10 of them with three
that
guns?
Was five of them.
As you guys can imagine, people are asking me if we fought back. But let me tell you, when you have more than one gun, it's not worth it. It's just material possessions. Besides, it's better to lose a moment from your life than your life in a moment. Because a bullet is more powerful than a fist. If there were no guns involved, it would be a no-brainer. I would put the money on the boxers blindfolded. With one arm, they would knock all these guys out. Just the lack of respect for the athletes was shocking, especially because in another situation, I could totally see these suspects cheering for these boxers, being their biggest fans. But let me know what your take is. What do you guys think about this? Lack of respect towards boxers in their neighborhood. In Los Angeles, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.